Welcome to KK Java Tutorials. In this video of Oracle tutorial, we are going to learn about the order by clause in Oracle. Yeah. So here you should understand the select statement returns rows in an arbitrary manner. For getting the resultant rows in a specified order, the order by clause is used in the SQL statement. Yeah. So let's try to understand through an example. Let's say I would like to write a query to list out the employee name and salary for all the employees in the department number 30 in the ascending order of their salary. Then how we can write a query? Very pretty simple. We'll have to write select then ename shall from emp, yeah, where dept num equals to 30, right? And lastly, we have to write order by, right? Order by sal. That's it. And we are done. Let me format this query. By pressing Control F7, you can format the query. Now, if I run this query, then let's see what's the outcome. Here you can see. Now, we have selected all the employees from department 30. And here you can see the record is basically sorted based on the basically salary, but this is default one is the ascending order. So one thing you should keep in mind, the default order is ascending, but using the keywords like ASC or DESC can explicitly specify the ordering. We can specify the order on the more than one column as well, that we will see. But here if you want a decreasing order, default is ASC over here, but if you want to specify, if you want to display the resultant the rows in descending order, then explicitly you can specify DESC. If I run, then you'll see your record will be displayed on the descending order. Yeah. Now, second thing, what we would like to see here, order by, you can specify on the more than one column as well, right? So let's say I'm going to copy this query, same query, and paste it out over here. Let's say I would like to basically sort my query, my selected resultant result based on the two columns, employee name as well as salary. So how will I write employee name, column salary? What do you mean by this? If I run this query, then almost we will get the same result. But here, what's the difference between previous query and this query? In this query, when we write order by ename and salary, so wherever ename means employee name are same, then sorting will happen on the salary, right? That's the meaning. So you can specify more than one column in order wise as well, right? Next thing I would like to say you in the order by clause, you may include integers that represent the relative position of the column in the select list. Let's say here in this query, let me add one more column. Let's say I'm going to select job as well, right? And if I run this query, then this will work perfectly fine, not a problem at all, right? But here, instead of column name, what you can do, you can specify the column position, right? This is select, okay. In order by, here you can, instead of specify the column name, you can specify the column position. So how we can specify the column position using integer? So in select query, you can see how you have selected. First is the ename, then salary, then job. The first ename is integer value 1, then 2, then 3. So here you can see, you can write 1 comma 2, means 1 represents ename and 2 represents salary. Instead of specifying the column name, you can specify the column index as well, right? And this will work perfectly fine. This is the thing I wanted to show you in this video tutorial. Now next thing I would like to tell you, there are certain key points always you keep in mind when you work with the order by clause. First, the order by clause must be the last clause. Here you can see last clause. Always in select query, you will have to write order by as a last clause. Now, second point, the order by clause is the only way to retrieve rows in the specific order, either in ascending or in descending. Now, third point, you will have to keep in mind, the columns that are not in the select list may still appear in the order by clause. Let's say here I am selecting basically here in this query, I am just trying to, if you specify the basically index, then column name you will have to specify. But if we do not specify the index, right, then here here you can see in first query you can see here I am selecting ename and salary, right? But only basically here one thing I would like to show you. Let's say here we are selecting ename and salary, but salary is present in the order by clause, but it's not mean that salary will have to specify in the select. Here let's say I am going to select job, name and job, but in order by clause I can mention the column salary, which is not basically mentioned in the select clause, and this should work, right? Only thing is that this record has been sorted based on the salary. Based on the salary, this is sorted or not, that you cannot see on the result. But if you want to see whether salary has been sorted or not, then you have to specify this column, right? Just check to see whether result has been sorted based on the salary or not. But it's not mean that whatever column name you specify in the order class, that should be present in the this select column list. Yeah, so that's the thing you need to keep in mind. That's all I have in this video tutorial, guys. Big thank you, and see you there in the next video tutorial.